Jerry Landers, he's a legend in the industry. He has been, always was. Everybody knew Jerry.
He was the first employee salesperson we ever had.
Jerry was able to reach out into some markets and areas that we weren't able to.
He changed some of the outlook and brought much more effective sales orientation when the people using our equipment weren't engineers anymore.
Since my dad's involvement in bringing Jerry on, we've been able to increase our sales 7 to 10-fold pretty easily.
The great thing about Jerry is that when he'd come out to teach a crew, it wasn't just an instruction, it was entertainment. He was the guy that said, "What is this? Anyone?" Just hold up a safety case ground for the underground locator. And they're like, "It's a safety ground." He said, "No, this thing is the thing that keeps somebody from fishing off your boat, petting your dog, mowing your grass. This is the thing that makes you come home in as good a condition as you left for work." He was in touch with the day-to-day work of the linemen, and he did a great job of training me and training the crews at the same time.
You know, he's very straightforward to the linemen. You know, tells it like it is. He's, you know, he's an awesome guy.
Jerry wound up managing a lot of our reps, our outside reps. Then he brought on others like Chris and Lewis and Steve and James, his son, to further expand that.
Jerry was one of these individuals who was able to combine all his technical skills with humor and good nature, and everybody really enjoyed Jerry.
Probably the biggest role Jerry supplied for us, kind of a cheerleader, kept us motivated, let us know we were important, and was always there to help us no matter what the issue may be.
Before I started, I asked him a lot of these questions just about the company and the job and what I would be doing, and he talked more to me about just life lessons, things in life, really nothing to do with work. He was very much a family man, and he always made that a priority. He kind of taught me to make sure that was, you know, your family's got to be taken care of first before anything else.
I met Jerry when I went to work for Maine Electrical Sales. Went to Jerry and I said, you know what? I said, I've been doing line work for 25 years in Missouri and I've never heard of Vaughn. He said, really? He said, you want to rep us? I said, yes. And it all, you know, it all started from there.
Anybody knows Jerry knows he's a staunch Republican. And I said, Jerry, I said, you'll be so proud of me. I said, you won't believe I've got a Hillary Clinton sticker on the back of my car now. And Jerry just went off and gave me a 15-minute speech about Donald Trump and how I should vote for him. So just typical Jerry. I just loved him to death and thought the world of him. So.
There's been a lot of great times, and some of the greatest times have been with traveling with Jerry.
Traveling with him a lot, I could tell what he ate the day before by what he had on his shirt.
We were going to go to Crested Butte, Colorado for a show.
Out to the Coolidge Dam for the Bureau of Indian Affairs.
3-4 in the morning, we'd start making calls and take off and come back at midnight, and he wouldn't stop talking.
We're weaving through the mountains, and the whole time Jerry is talking, and he's talking, and he's talking, and he's talking.
And it was a long drive, tough roads.
We drove 18, 20 hours, and he'd talk a dog off a meat wagon.
Thinking to myself, is this guy going to talk during this whole trip? He's going to drive me crazy.
He's got his coffee going, and we're just thumping, and we got the machine on the back.
So what I started doing was I started driving a little faster. So pretty soon Jerry's got a hold of the side of the handle on the truck, and he's going back and he's forth, and he's going back and he's forth.
Dropped him off at the hotel, I get there, I'm ringing his room the next morning at 6, and I'm banging on the door, no answer.
There was a lot of road construction, and I said, holy shit. And we kind of went off this like 6-inch thing.
And then he looks at me and he says, what the heck you doing, son?
Everything in the cabin came up. Coffee like over us, over the back.
So I go to the front desk, I go to the lady, he's not answering the door, I've rang his phone, the guy's always up in the morning, he works 100 hours a week. I go, you gotta open the door.
So I proceeded to stop the truck alongside the road and look him square between the eyes and say, if you call me son one more time, those are fighting words.
I think there's something wrong. So I get down to the room, she opens the door.
So of course we get there, and by that big old bounce we had, we get the machine off, we're gonna do our demo, and it didn't work. Couldn't get the damn thing started.
And he asked me, he says, how come you're driving so darn fast around all these corners? And I said, because you're driving me crazy with your mouth running.
So I go over there and I poke him and I'll say, jumps up.
Jerry says, hold on a second there, John.
What are you doing? You're bothering me. I said, Jerry, we gotta go. He goes, oh. Reaches over, grabs a shirt with last night's meal, puts it on, he goes, let's go.
Jerry was a heck of a guy when you got to know him, and he could torque you off as fast as he could make you happy.
And he goes over and he just kicks the damn thing. Boop! Comes up, screened it, nailed the demo, sold him the unit.
Call him anytime, he'd answer the phone, and his number was 352-408-7890.
Jerry was a personality in and of himself, but he's left his personality interdispersed amongst the industry, whether it be old colleagues or it be competitors. There was always a mutual respect, and it didn't matter what portion of the industry you were in. If you had a relationship with Jerry, you had a relationship with Jerry, and you knew that, and you knew where you stood, and it was a genuine concern for his fellow man. Good-hearted person, good-hearted man.